And you know, it's so true. I when I work with my clients whether they have kids or families or their teachers or whatever it is that they do, I say, you know what? You'll notice a complete difference when you feel more empowered, when you eliminate your obstacles that are in the way of you feeling more present and more of who you are. Then it's amazing how much easier it is and how much more effective we are when we work with other people.
Yeah, exactly. And all of our lives, we're taught to have our awareness outside of ourselves. For instance, one of my personal philosophies of life is that life is like a homeopathic remedy. It always gives us a little bit of the poison, poison, so to speak, or a little bit of the imbalance that we're carrying inside. For instance, say that I have an inner picture that says, from my childhood, I'm unlovable. So some kind of situation will keep coming up in my life to show that to me until I can clear it, release it, come more into my wholeness.
Personalize is what I call those, I'm unlovable and I'm not good enough,
That's great.
And I think that this is such a time on the planet right now that we're really being asked to clear all that up, and have to take more personal responsibility and really eliminate everything, all those personal lies that are in the way of us feeling good and being more of who we are, because I'm unlovable is so not true.
Because
I know that you are lovable, Julie.
And was the guy from Saturday Night Live. And I like me.
I know the lady on the last show is like, I am fabulous, And I mean, really, how good does that feel to say that, to say I am lovable? And it's, we don't have to do anything to be lovable or to be good enough or to be fabulous. We just really need to eliminate everything that's in the way of that. Because by the virtue of just breathing air, we're already lovable.
It goes back to, as you said, peeling the onion. It's taking off the layers of programming that we've all our lives been kind of layered with. And a lot of that programming gives the power of ourselves to something else, whether it be the medical industry, church, government, etc. And then suddenly we no longer know who we are, that, oh, wait a minute, I have my answers inside.
And whoever we think we are, whatever story we're telling ourselves in that moment, is going to be our point of attraction. So people wonder why they're getting what they're getting, and why do I keep marrying that same guy over and over and over again? Yeah. Well, if you keep running the same program, you're going to keep attracting the person that's going to show you where you're out of alignment with your divine nature and where you're not lovable.
A lot of that, though, is on the unconscious. So we may think certain things. I can say I'm fabulous. But if there's a stronger program in my unconscious that says the opposite, then that will create that next experience. And some of the psychic work is, I think of it as a spiritual enema. It's a real cleansing. So with the psychic work, it's all you going into meditation, looking with the sixth chakra, which is clairvoyance. Clairvoyance is just clear seeing. Just like the word psychic, one meaning of it is soul essence. To be able to see from a soul perspective instead of just a one-dimensional place. Then you can look at what we call pictures, and pictures being those beliefs, those hidden unconscious places that are creating a lot of what's going on in my life that I don't want, perhaps. And when you see them, that's power. That's quantum physics. Whatever you observe, you affect.
Right.
So it's just taking awareness to ourselves that starts to create the change. But often, don't we in life, we resist what doesn't feel good. And in this work, especially where I've evolved with it, it's what we call neutrality, just a total allowing of being present with. That there's not a good or a bad to it. Energy is neutral. And it's just being present.
And it needs to move. Don't you think that energy has to move? It only knows how to do one thing.
That's the only way it works.
Exactly.
It's like electricity in that way. It has to move. You're right.
You know, I know that on Wednesday nights, I read in your newsletter that on Wednesday nights that you do a free healing class. I think it was from 5:30 to 6:30 at the center. And I went last Wednesday, I went when we set up this interview, and it was really amazing. It was like, oh yeah, I remember this. This is really cool. And everything came back. So what, I know you kind of walk around and you do some energy work. I mean, I could certainly feel it. And you're also giving a chat while you're doing that. So tell us a little bit about how that works and what you're doing.
pretty much I was just making my grocery list while So it's a spiritual healing, and what I am doing is feeling your energy, but also looking psychically to see what's happening and noticing where the blocks are. Mm. Like, say, whoever comes to the free weekly healing clinic will come usually with an intention. I'm having this relationship issue, or, geez, I want a new job. I'm in transition, whatever it is. And so what I'm doing is I'm working with you, helping you to release whatever isn't in alignment with what you're wanting to bring in. And then I'm noticing what's happening. Perhaps I'll see some pictures come up. What you're working on is a spirit in the body. And I kind of give you that spiritual hello to say, hi, I know that you're beyond this body. You're the eternal being within the body. So you can create all these changes you want. And mostly it's the person that's doing the healing. In essence, we always heal ourselves.
Right.
And spiritual healing is the beginning of change. So it's something that will, what I often tell people when you leave there, and just keep having awareness, pay attention for the next days to a week, you'll keep releasing energy.
Yeah, I remember when we were doing Ideal, which was about transition, you know, we're closing the Mind Over Matter bookstore. I know it's really sad. We're just temporarily, we're actually going to be moving it. So I'll let you know where that's going to be. But that's one of the things I was talking mm-hmm. about, is that I'm having this huge transition right now, and I'm kind of curious about what's next. And you were focusing or talking a lot about my back, and that I was releasing stuff, and it was all about trust, which was such a perfect thing for me to hear, that T word once again, you know. But it changed, you know. It was interesting, because as soon as I got into the car, I really, like you said, it just, I felt like all the release still happening. It's like, mm-hmm. oh wow, I felt like you were still there in the car with me. It was kind of fun. Mm-hmm. And I really focused on it. I love, you know, when I get information, I love to just work it. I figure, you know, I went, mm-hmm. I had the session, mm-hmm. I got this information, I'm going to do something with it. So I've been working on the trust issue, and mm-hmm. things are really shifting and changing. And all these, it's funny how when you get the permission or you start allowing, what yeah. can show up.
Isn't that exciting?
It's really, really exciting.
What we can have.
So thank you for that healing. It was really fun. It was really...
And also what I love about my work is, as I give you a healing, I'm healing myself. That I am, whatever shows up in our world, whatever kind of experience or person, is a healing opportunity for me to release out of my own space. So then I, in turn, can give you a healing and start to release my pictures around trust. And ultimately that it's whatever I notice outside of me is actually for me to heal in me. Which I love that.
Yeah.
You know, I was listening to something, some kind of radio show this morning, and the person was saying that the meaning of individual means not separate or not divided from the whole.
Yeah.
Which I thought was fascinating. For instance, in the work we do, it is about, okay, being able to know what is my energy, what's my space, what is my truth. And it gave me a different perspective of it, the importance of that. When I can see myself, then I can feel my wholeness and connection with everything, all that is.
And that's why I breathe air.
Besides the fact, if you didn't, you'd die, Mitch.
Yeah, right.
Do you mind if I just share a few other things that we do at the center?
No, that's what I was just going to ask you.
How psychic
you read my
of
mind.
You. I don't So we have every week that free healing clinic that one can just drop in on Wednesdays between 5:30 and 6:30. I usually teach a couple workshops every month and various topics. For instance, the last ones I did, healing the chakras. This month I have one called self-love. Mm. We have a monthly healing and meditation service, one Sunday a month. We have readings by appointment every Monday night. So advanced students who've been training in this work, they read a person for an hour who comes in. It's part of their training.
Oh, excellent.
And then there are 6-week classes. There's a year-long advanced training, a self-healing, clairvoyant training, and then beyond.
So when people graduate or they do the advanced classes, do they go out and do now what you do, or do they usually stay in the center? And like, how does all that work? What's the benefit of taking the classes? And
yeah.
Is it mostly to work on yourself? Is it so people could learn mm-hmm. these techniques to work on other people as well?